Trump and Kim Jong Un's weird bromance baffles Colbert, Noah, and Meyers. Donald Trump's North Korea summit in Singapore is officially behind us, which means it's time to take a deep breath and assess the damage, much like when one comes to a screeching stop after a car crash. All told, things could have been worse. The president avoided any nuclear mistakes, and got dictator Kim Jong Un to sign a nonproliferation agreement. The bad news is the president now seems to have developed a deep admiration for Kim, and that agreement is just further proof that Trump didn't actually write the art of the deal. As Stephen Colbert put it on The Late Show Tuesday night, Kim gave us so little. You have to promise more than Kim did when you signed the iTunes user agreement. And I'm not making that up. Turns out there's actually a portion of that agreement that prohibits users from using the technology to design, manufacture, or produce nukes. Who knew? As Colbert noted, what Trump actually got the US in this agreement was pretty underwhelming. Basically, North Korea agreed to work toward the denuclearization of the Korean Peninsula in exchange for the US halting joint military exercises with South Korea. For the record, South Korea did not know that was on the table, but what's worse, North Korea's vague concessions were simply a reaffirmation of an agreement Jong Un had already made with South Korea. It's like Trump saw North and South Korea getting together and was like, "That looks good, who's up for a three-way?" Colbert said. The leaders also agreed to a follow-up meeting at a later date. So the result of this meeting was to agree to another meeting, Colbert said. It's not exactly a nothing burger. It's more like a bun that says, we agree bilaterally to the potential future placement of meat somewhere in the toasted zone. When asked by George Stephanopoulos how he could trust a man who murders his own people, Trump demurred, "George, I'm given what I'm given." "He's given what he's given, okay," replied Colbert. "Kim kills his own people, but it's not like he kneeled during the national anthem." Alas, it would appear that our president has no qualms about expressing admiration for Kim Jong Un. As the two shook hands, Trump said it was his great honor to make the dictator's acquaintance, and in a press conference after the summit, he re-upped his assertion that Jong Un is talented. "Well, he is very talented," Trump told reporters. "Anybody who takes over a situation like he did at 26 years of age and is able to run it, and run it tough, I don and oppose semicolon t say and oppose semicolon he was nice and oppose, or I don and oppose semicolon t say anything about it. You don't give dictators points for being young," Colbert said. "That's like saying, you know, Vlad the Impaler became ruler at age 20. Nobody talks about that, everybody gets all hung up on the impaling part. Okay, not how young he was. He was the Mozart of sticking wood through people." On The Daily Show, Trevor Noah was equally flabbergasted, especially at Trump's greeting to Kim Jong Un as they shook hands. "You heard that right," the comedian said. President Trump said meeting Kim Jong Un was his great honor. I mean, then again, when you've appeared in a McDonald's commercial talking to Grimace, everything seems like an honor. Jokes aside, Noah noted that this meeting gave North Korea precisely what it has craved for decades: recognition on the world stage, and equal standing with the President of the United States. The two shook hands in front of a row of the two countries' flags standing side by side. Some may have seen that and thought, "Oh, Trump's being nice for now, but when he gets Kim alone in that negotiation room, he's gonna denuke his nuts off," Noah said. But it turns out only one man lost his nuts in that room. Like Colbert and other late-night hosts, Noah was unimpressed with the deal Trump walked away with. Donald Trump flew across the world to Singapore, and all he got was Kim Jong Un saying, "I'll think about giving up my nukes," Noah said. They could have done that over text. Because you realize, Kim didn't commit to anything. He basically Facebook-ersed a nuclear deal. Another bizarre wrinkle? Former basketball player Dennis Rodman was also present in Singapore, and appeared on CNN wearing a MAGA hat and a t-shirt, promoting a product called Potcoin. He also took a moment to thank a long list of people, including Pearl Jam frontman Eddie Vedder. As a baffled Seth Meyers put it on Late Night, "The news these days really feels like a Mad Lib from 1999. Dennis Rodman was in Singapore promoting Potcoin, where he thanked Eddie Vedder at a summit with North Korea and President Donald Trump. And, like his fellow comedians, Meyer seemed unable to believe the amount of praise our president heaped on a ruthless dictator. This is a guy who starves his own citizens and assassinates people with anti-aircraft guns, Meyer said. You're talking about him like he started Apple in his garage, but I guess it shouldn't surprise me that Trump's idea of talent is getting rich by taking over your dad's business. Trump was born on third base, whereas Kim was born on third base and then shot the third baseman. Oh, and let us not forget the moment when Trump's undying love for real estate got the better of him. Speaking with reporters, the president said, they have great beaches. You see that whenever they end oppose semicolon re-exploding their cannons into the ocean. I said, boy, look at that, wouldn't that make a great condo? Sure, it might be appalling that our president could look at a totalitarian country with such tunnel vision, but as Meyers noted, he accidentally told a great fucking joke. They have great beaches, you can see it when they're exploding their cannons into the oceans is a great fucking joke. Even when he's in a summit over nuclear weapons, he's still trying to sell a shitty hotel timeshare. Use of this site constitutes acceptance of our user agreement and privacy policy and cookie statement.